My fasting glucose is 81, and my A1C has dropped from 6.7 to 6, which means I'm pretty insulin sensitive. And within 2 months, I dropped 15 kilos. Now, if I wasn't on the diet that you guys recommend, I'd hate to think where I'd be. Life really wasn't worth living. I wanted to be there for my kids and grandkids, but my quality of life was so bad. When I was 110 kilos, that's 242 pounds, on a 5'7.5" frame, it wasn't easy to move. It wasn't easy to do anything. All I wanted to do is sit in front of the television and eat my chocolate and eat my cookies and whatever else I could get my hands on. It's only when I saw pictures of myself after my son's bar mitzvah that, that can't be me. You know, I don't look like that. That's not me. And that's where it all started. That's a long time ago. But I never really got my health back like it is now until I switched to the whole food diet. Steroids actually make you more insulin resistant. They also damage internal organs. In my case, it's my pancreas. I got the results of the CPAP back, and my pancreas is almost dead. The range is from 0.9 to 7. I'm at 1, which means my pancreas is really not producing much insulin. But my fasting blood sugar, my fasting glucose is 81, and my A1C has dropped from 6.7 to 6, which means I'm pretty insulin sensitive. Now, if I wasn't on the diet that you guys recommend, I'd hate to think where I'd be. Because I'm pretty much close to being type 1, and I will be in the next couple of years. But that is what it is. But it's only your diet and the advice from you guys that's keeping me normal, not needing medication, not needing insulin. That's where I was when I started exactly a year ago. But it took me 5 months before I transitioned. I'm not OCD, but I'm OD, which is obsessive disorder. It's like Texas Hold'em. I always go all in. And if I don't know what I'm doing, I don't do it. I was a cheese addict. I'd keep a kilo of cheese in the fridge and eat it every 2 or 3 days. But I was eating a healthy diet, you see. And when I had the diagnosis, I said, I'm eating a healthy diet. I'm not drinking cola. I'm not eating sugar. I ate cookies. I'm a cookie addict as well. I was a cookie addict. And that's when Cyrus and Robbie started to talk about cutting the fat, and type 2 diabetes is fat being in cells that are not meant to store fat.
Just like you guys said, insulin resistance is caused by the storage of fat in tissues that are not designed to store fat. So remember that. Insulin resistance is caused by the storage of fat in tissues that are not designed to store fat. From now on, you guys are world's experts in insulin resistance. If anybody asks you, what is it, you repeat that sentence right there.
Fat being in cells that are not meant to store fat. That's when the light bulb went off. And that's when I switched 100% to whole food, plant-based, limited oil, salt, and sugar, no animal products, no processed foods. And within 2 months, I dropped 15 kilos. Food doesn't have to be complicated to be tasty. And once I made the switch and I said, food is fuel, nothing more, then it became easy. I'm down to 30% lung function, which in reality, I should be in my flat apartment with a bottle of oxygen next to me and unable to move. That's a medical reality. But in reality, I still work a full day. I still ride my bike about 250 kilometers a week. But every winter, I normally can't breathe. I find it very difficult, except for this winter. I went through this winter with no problems, and that can only be the diet. And looking at the science, because I'm also a bit of a science nerd, the way I'm eating has reduced inflammation. So if I'm reducing inflammation everywhere, the lungs are less inflamed, which means breathing is going to be easier. So it makes sense from a scientific point of view. No inflammation, breathing's easier, and so I feel great eating this way. The first 4 months, I didn't do anything. I learned. I wanted to know where I could get my calcium, because as we know, cows don't make calcium. It's number 20 on the periodic table, so they can't make calcium. But I wanted to know what I could eat to get my calcium, what I had to eat to get my protein, what I had to eat to meet my nutritional needs. So I spent 4 to 5 months learning. And once I'd learned and made a list of everything where I could get all the nutrition I needed to know about zinc and magnesium and phosphorus and iodine, because a lot of the salt here is not iodized. And once I'd learned all of that, then the transition was easy. And once I'd heard the testimonials about carbohydrates don't cause type 2 diabetes, it's fat, then the transition was easy. And I don't like to use the word vegan, because vegan can be just as unhealthy as any other diet. I take steroids. Actually, since I've gone this way, I've cut out about 4 medications. I've cut out calcium tablets with vitamin D. I've cut out the statins. And, all right, my cholesterol, what is it? Was 177, but with my HDL at 76, which is a great ratio, so I'm not worried about it. It was at 276, my cholesterol. So it's come down. And it's come down since I've dropped the statins. I've dropped aspirin. So I realize I don't need it. I'm getting enough vitamin K from the berries that I'm eating. 4 medications, gone.